Wenn wir zum Meckes gehen.
Yoga!
Hm? Der da.
Are you ready? Perfect. Then.
What's your name and what do you do at Sonnenwagen?
My name is Frederik Aun. I'm the treasurer and head of sponsoring for Sonnenwagen Aachen. So my job is related to our partners and our financials, and yeah, that's everything that's under my supervision.
Hi, my name is Lina Schwering. I'm part of the sponsoring team here at Team Sonnenwagen Aachen and also participated a lot in the manufacturing, specifically the structure.
I'm Simon Quinker. I'm the co-team manager and I'm also the head of marketing. That means I'm responsible for everything that you see from us that is published, that is produced, like social media or our website. Oder muss das jetzt so ein bisschen?
Nein, nein, nein.
Ja.
What does it mean for you to be a member of Sonnenwagen Aachen?
What does it mean for me to be a member? As I started to join the team, what was really important for me, or what was really great about the team, was that it combined the aspects of environment, of sustainability, of environment-focused work, with the student, being a student. That was really interesting to get the theoretical knowledge that every student collects during their studies and brings that into this very practical project where we combine solar energy, we combine mobility into one, and we innovate in that space really and think about energy efficiency in a whole new level. And this is really fascinating to me. And still to that date, I think that's a really, really interesting and really, really great part about Sonnenwagen, that we think outside of the box to get not only the best solar car, but also think about the stuff that comes with that bring that to life and show the new generations that solar energy, mobility can be one, but also innovations arise from that transcend on not only this solar car part.
I think for me it means to have something that we've created from scratch. Like, I don't think that anyone who has not done something like this before doesn't understand what it means to have a car going on a road after 2 years of just an intense experience. I think there were such highs and also lows that are indescribable, and always working together with a team that has exactly the same goal and does not give up, just like you. And then you are kind of in this wave where we are all working towards the same thing, and I think I cannot think of anything that is as satisfying as that. So yeah, I think that's what is the important thing for me in this team.
A lot of things, I would say. It's pretty hard to get it down to one point. I think what's making it the most fun for me is the spirit around this team, because nothing seems out of reach. You know, you come in the office and you talk to people and you have a really crazy idea, or you think, it's not possible. You get in there, but you kind of tell somebody while you have a lunch break, and then they're like, well, I wouldn't say it's not possible at least. And then you come back in office and everybody is like, okay, let's wrap our head around this. If we could do it like this, this could work. And you wouldn't know how many parts in this car started out with a conversation like this. And that's what makes it so impressive to me to be a part of this team. And this is something I really want to take out of this for the rest of my life, nothing is impossible until you prove me otherwise. And this is just amazing. This sums up the whole Sonnenwagen spirit pretty well, I think. So a season for Sonnenwagen starts after the biggest race of the last season. So for me, it started December 2019 when I joined the team after they returned from Australia from the World Solo Challenge back then. And the season starts normally with a big recruitment time where we gather all of the students of Aachen to come and hopefully be a member of Sonnenwagen. And then we have like 6 or 7 months where we introduce them into their jobs, show them around, teach them the skills that the last team gathered to get them smoothly into their jobs.
Then starting with an innovation phase, which means we think about really innovative things that we can implement in our solo car that make it really the edge, to have the edge of the other teams, to get it really, really aerodynamically and energy efficient. And after that innovation phase, so the end point of that innovation phase is marked by the World Environment Day, which is in June, where the official regulations for the World Solar Challenge, the challenge we aim to participate in, are released. And that means we now know what car we can exactly build, discuss all the innovation we thought of, and look if they fit to the regulations, and then go full steam ahead into the development of the car itself in full detail.
So manufacturing starts in January, and I think the biggest part, the biggest team effort, is to build the structural components of the car. So anything that you see that is carbon, the outer shell, as well as the monocoque, which protects our driver, are handmade, manufactured. And that takes a lot of hours and a lot of effort by every single team member that we have. Yeah, when you start building a solo car, our team already has a lot of knowledge, but we don't know everything. Impossible to do that. We are all students and we have experience, but not necessarily in every manufacturing option that we have at hand. And then came in partners that were really on our side in the sense of meetings every single week, passing on the knowledge that they gathered to make sure that was included in the PHOTON. For example, we use software that we've never used before, we use manufacturing methods that we never used before, and all along we had people that talked to us and gave us their advice, reflected on things, came up with new ideas, and yeah, this advice was invaluable. We couldn't have done it without it. Yeah, this year, for the first time, we started working with prepreg, which is a specific kind of carbon that we are allowed to use, which allowed us to be even more lightweight. And this is kind of what I love about this club. We look at something, we're like, this is new, this is something we've never tried before, it looks cool, let's try it. And then we did. We worked together with our partners, and in hours and hours of sleepless nights included, we built a really good structure for our, which allowed us to be really, really aerodynamic, to call the aerodynamic ideas that we had into account, and made it work and had a really, really nice car.
As our team, the endeavor is to build a solar car in these 2 years. And then suddenly in February, we got the message after many long meetings with the teams and with the event organizers from the World Solar Challenge, that the World Solar Challenge as planned cannot take part this year due to corona restrictions from the Australian government. And that suddenly means the shock to us that we can't participate in the race we built the car itself for.
So yeah, also in sponsoring, the pandemic had quite some impacts, because we were quite afraid that because we didn't know how deeply the financial crisis would get because of the pandemic, that we would get trouble gaining new sponsors, or having trouble with our like remaining sponsors to continue their partnership with us. But the opposite was the case. Actually, all the partners stood by. We gathered so many new partners during that winter that we are happily having in our Sonnenwagen family. And this wasn't a too big problem for the pandemic.
And then we started collecting the email addresses of all the other teams, writing to them what their plans are, because they are in a similar situation than us. And we got together as the solar family, created our own Slack channel, Regularly had meetings discussing opportunities to create a new challenge that can take place in Europe or close to Europe. And then we decided on the Solar Challenge Morocco with support by the government. And then we were pursuing not only building the solar car, but also helping to build this whole new challenge that we can participate instead of the World Solar Challenge. After many setbacks that we had due to Corona and then the challenge that has been cancelled, we finally agreed on two challenges for this year, the European Solar Challenge and the Solar Challenge in Morocco. And that meant we had a goal for a team. We could finally go full steam into the production of the car, actually build it. That was a fantastic feeling to get into it. And that meant our next goal was to actually show the car to the world at our rollout event in August. And it was now time to actually build the car and get it on the road.